research can be a very long journey, starting in the backroom labs and evolving into a massive multi-million dollar project involving researchers across the country. The quest to create a life-changing bionic eye is one such example.
The goal of our project is to produce a retinal implant to enable people who have lost their sight to be able to restore a sense of vision. So the sorts of conditions that we're targeting are for those who have lost their photoreceptors, so these are the cells that convert light to electrical impulses at the back of the eye. Two major groups are retinitis pigmentosa, which is an inherited form of retinal degeneration, and age-related macular degeneration, which primarily affects people as they're growing older and affects an increasing number of people in our society.
What we're doing with the bionic eye is we are attempting to replace those photoreceptors with a device, and we can hopefully replace sight for profoundly blind people.
This is our prototype bionic eye. It consists of two cameras that capture an image. They're mounted on these glasses. The image is sent to our processing unit and converts it into a series of stimulation commands that are sent to a transmitter that is mounted here behind the ear.
Then the signals come to an implant, which is placed on top of the eye, with a small incision made in the side of the eye so that we can slide an electrode array around to the back of the retina. It receives these instructions from Nigel's system, and that causes a signal to go down the optic nerve and be interpreted as vision by the patient.
I was honoured to be chosen to be one of three people in Australia to give back to research and technology and to help my fellow blind person is what I was wanting to do. It felt wonderful that I saw this flicker of light that looked like a candle light that I probably blew out when I was 18, and I've never seen one since until 12 months ago, which was just wonderful.
Yes!
You! Really?
Yeah, just like a little quick flash.
Great.
Yes, the Thunderbirds are going.
Good on you.
Yeah, very, it was just like...
It's been 15 months since I've been implanted, not really knowing what the journey was going to be like, but excited to be a part of it. Yeah, what we've done in the testing has been amazing. I can recognise and work out letters and numbers through the camera. Rather than just seeing the phosphenes, it made sense. So in that way, it was it was really exciting. A real, eureka moment. Was really fantastic.
I'd like to see the future of this project move even further than just the team that are working on at the moment. I'd like to see and be able to assist it so that if it certainly doesn't assist me, we can get this into third world countries and other people will certainly benefit by it.
There's only been two highlights probably in the last 30 years, and one was getting my first guide dog and probably seeing again through the Bionic Eye program. The first time I saw a letter this year was the first time I'd seen one in 30 years, and it was just wonderful and exhilarating and mind-blowing.
We never thought that this would be quite the journey it's been. It's taken us 15 years, so it has been a slog. But along the way, we've forged some amazing partnerships. We've created some brilliant technology, state-of-the-art technology.
And I guess what keeps us going with this research is that we know that the end point is someone that really can't see anything is that you're going to be able to see something with this device, and that is going to be a wonderful reward, and it gets us motivated every day to do this right.